It's 12 o'clock on... Hey, I'm Dave.
And I'm Craig.
And this is the Wizard Product Review on this week's show. And it's kind of like a prelude to Blackpool
it
show,
is.
Isn't
Blackpool's
it?
When you look at this, Blackpool's actually probably going to be on the next day, isn't
we'll
it?
We'll be there.
We'll be there. We'll be setting up the stand.
Now, we've had quite a bit of beer turn up.
Yeah, you'll notice, and not just normal beer, but American beer. This is really exciting. I've never heard of White Shield Indian Pale Ale before.
And this came courtesy of Paper Crane Productions.
Thank you, Paper Crane.
For the David Berglass quote. I think they didn't get your apology. Unfortunately,
no.
They probably crossed over. But don't worry, Paper Crane. We're going to review the beer.
That's a good idea.
We're going to actually review the beer and we'll get back to you on what it was like. But thank you. Also, we can't actually send it all back anyway because Jim Traynor was in this morning and quite a few bottles have mysteriously disappeared into his boot for a party this weekend.
But we have had an idea, haven't we?
We've had a great idea.
What we're going to do what we're going to do, we're going to take one of the Paper Crane products that are currently sitting at the bottom of our review pile and we're going to bump it straight up to the top of the list. So on this week's show, the first thing we're going to look at is Function 9
by Kaylin Morelli. Now, before we start, because we've had a look at this morning, we have to do something.
Yeah, we do.
Something that's never been done on the Wizard product review before to such an extent.
Yep.
Kaylin Morelli, this goes out to you. Because this guy is officially the hottest name in magic.
And this DVD is the best DVD on visual close-up magic that I have seen in the last 10 years. Forget about everything else that we've given a massive, brilliant, grade review for, because all that was good, but it pales in comparison to this DVD.
This isn't just Worker of the Week. This is DVD of the Year. This is Worker of the Year so far. This DVD is incredible.
It's very rare to find a DVD where there is not one single thing, and we rip DVDs apart. We like to pick on stuff. There is absolutely nothing to pick on.
We have had to sit through so much crap in the last 12 months. Kaylin, where have you been?
Seriously,
we're waiting for.
We were sitting through G's DVD last week, pulling our hair out. You could have been here saving us.
This was on the shelf. We didn't even know. Right, we're going to go through a few of these tricks. We're going to put some clips on the screen.
Because you need to see how visual these are. The first trick on the DVD, VGH.
Well, that's a sandwich routine.
It's a sandwich routine.
It doesn't really get you off. And I wouldn't have put that on the DVD first because it's not the best trick.
I'd say it's the weakest effect on the DVD.
Yes.
But it's still very strong. If you've seen Paul Harris's Grasshopper, what Kaylin's done is he's taken the Grasshopper concept, but he's put it, basically he's put it on steroids. So
it's awesome.
A selected card is lost in the deck. The spectator's holding on to two black aces. You take two red aces and you magnetize the card out the deck. It looks really good when touch the aces
very
to
good.
The deck. The card and instantly jumps out the deck in between the red aces, then vanishes from between the red aces, and the sign card is now in the spectator's
hand. This is not
hand.
Magical tidbits as well. Every single thing on this DVD is a really good commercial routine. And it's very rare these days that I see things on a DVD and I think, I want to do that.
Yeah.
I want to learn that. I want to stop everything that I'm doing
mm-hmm.
and learn this trick right
well,
now.
Here's something for you, Dave. There's 12 routines on the DVD. On the trailer and all the ad copy, Kaylin says there's 9.
Yeah, what's
but
he on
there's
about?
There's 12. There's 3 routines that he considers bonus routines.
Yeah, which is a bit ridiculous because they're actually better than anything that are on most DVDs these days.
And a perfect example is the follow-on to VGH, which is VGHB, which all I can say is you have 2 red aces, 2 black aces. The selection is put face down in between the black aces.
Incredible.
And it looks like 3 fly with cards. You've got the black aces here. The selection jumps from between the black aces to the red aces, jumps back again, visually jumps, and the spectator can examine everything. By the way, these 2 effects I'm talking about, a regular deck of cards, no extras, no gimmicks, impromptu, anytime, anywhere.
Trick of the DVD for me, pen in bottle.
Go on. What do you
Absolutely mean? Unbelievable. This guy, His misdirection is absolutely fantastic.
I'd even go so far to say it's Tommy Wonder level.
He's absolutely brilliant. He's entertaining to watch. He's such a refreshing, urban, contemporary style. Yep. And yet the magic is beautiful. Yep. He kind of has his shoe. He tips out a pen, first of all.
Yep.
And then the pen falls out. And he says, that's not what was bothering me. And then he produces a bottle of water from his shoe.
Which is a great application
That'd
of her
That'd be
shoes.
Enough for most things.
Yeah.
That would be enough, but then he cleanly shows
this is just unbelievable.
He turns it around, there's nothing in the bottle at all, and he visually puts the pen into the bottle and you can hand it straight to
and
them.
And show your hands empty.
It looks absolutely incredible. It's not YouTube magic.
It's not. You would look at
this. We played around with this and we were like, oh my God, it works.
I want to do this. And you know, on the subject of that, his crediting is exceptional.
Yes.
He spends about 2 or 3 minutes before every explanation talking about his inspiration, his history of the effect. Like, compare this to G last week where he doesn't understand.
Don't even talk about it.
No,
leave
let's
it.
Not even talk about it. The crediting is exceptional. Right, next up, you've got transport.
Unbelievable. Again, a beautiful misdirection effect. I love things like card under glass, that sort of thing.
Yeah.
Where the spectator doesn't see something and then, oh my God, it's there. Imagine this, two cell phones. You've got your phone, their phone. You give them your phone to hold on to. They've got it on their hand. You wrap an elastic band around their phone. The band then visually disappears right in front of your face. The magic is here, right in the sweet spot. Amazingly, the band is around the phone on their hand.
That they've been holding. This guy does some of the best rubber band material I've ever seen. He makes rubber bands cool. Forget about the phone thing, although that's excellent. He has something called transport bonus. He doesn't even count this as a trick.
Oh.
But it's stronger than most rubber band tricks I've ever seen. He's got some rubber bands around his wrist. He borrows a ring. He takes the ring. He rubs it onto the rubber bands. And it instantly links on there.
It's
instantly.
On there. It's
he
on
shows
there.
It's on there. He then takes the rubber bands and slowly, he penetrates it through the rubber bands. Everything's examinable.
And it's their ring. And lots of people have bands on their wrist.
On their wrist. And if you do any ring and band stuff, like Russell Lee's rubber ringer off the Band Around DVDs, that's a great routine to do before you go into a longer routine. He doesn't even count that as a trick, guys. That's a bonus. It's not counted
it
in his mind as a trick.
It could be a one-trick DVD.
And he doesn't even mention it on the ad copy. This guy's insane.
He
you are insane.
He just calls it a bonus.
Right, look, let's keep going on. It's two DVDs because the explanations are so
they're like in a cinema or something like that.
It's in
that.
A cinema.
Sometimes he has a studio performance and then
no, he's always got live performances on the street. Then he's always got studio performances. Then he breaks down each individual phase and he's got over the shoulder shot to music. And when you have to make a gimmick, he does that thing where the cameras...
It shows
not,
you just
we used
enough.
To joke about the paper crane moment.
The paper crane have improved, seriously.
Seriously, they really have. It's so, so easy to learn. Okay, so what else have we got going on? Suspended. What's going on there?
Suspended. He's holding a rubber band balanced on another band. The top band just visually disappears.
It goes away. It's not there. It vanishes.
And then he just gives them the two bands again.
It's stupidly
We've got to hurry
insane.
Up. We're okay, running out of time.
Loaded.
Card under shoe. And then repeat card under shoe, and then the deck's under the shoe.
Everyone's been doing card under box ever since James Brown brought it into popularity. Everybody's been doing it and coming up with their variation. This guy has really taken it to a new level. It's exactly the same as card under box, but the deck goes under your shoe, the card goes under your shoe, perfect for walk around, perfect for strolling, perfect for street.
Sum up the last couple of
loaded,
routines.
Loaded two, that's another one he doesn't count as a trick, where the deck goes into his hat.
He makes the sunglasses appear.
And the sunglasses appear, which looks
then
so
the
cool.
Card's in the hat, and then the deck's in his hat.
It's just awesome.
He just beats them up with magic, this guy.
This next one is the trick of my trick of the DVD. Friction. Band the bill and the clip.
Oh, borrowed it bill.
Folds it up. Puts it on.
They put it around the elastic band.
They put
a clip on there. Holds it. Melts through.
And it's done up here in the face, so you can really see it. Great for a TV spot. You're awesome, Kaylin. I love you. Anyway, sugar freak. Gum to mouth.
Oh, unbelievable. Packet of gum. He says, watch this. Bang. The gum just vanishes and it's immediately in his mouth. It looks awesome.
It really does. And finally, and I can't get my head around this.
Get your head around this.
I just can't get my head around this. Transit was an effect that was brought out by Theory 11 by Kaylen just a couple of months ago. You spent about 20 quid. You got this transit trick, which looks a little bit like Garrett Thomas's banded, but in all honesty, I think it's more organic and better because you take an elastic band, you wrap it around your finger, it jumps from finger to finger to finger to finger to your thumb, back to your other thumb, and you hand it out.
It's on the DVD.
It's on the DVD.
I can't believe it.
How you can put a 20 quid trick on a DVD? It's stupid.
What has happened to Paper Crane Magic? It's not the beer talking.
You know, Paper Crane, you've always had good production values. We've ragged on you in the past. Some of your past DVDs haven't been the best. We've ragged on you, but we've always said your production values are good. Well, guess what? Paper Crane have now officially arrived.
Kaylen Morelli, it's the best magic DVD of the last 10 years. Some of the most visual close-up magic I have ever bloody seen. I can't wait to shake your hand. I hope you're going to be at Magic Live.
I really want to meet you.
You are my new favourite magician. You're the hottest name in magic. 99%.
Forget about 99%. 100%. I cannot imagine anybody beating this DVD. We love you, Kaylen. We want to see more of you. Please bring out more material. You are the man.
Right, so this show's going out a couple of days before Blackpool.
Yeah, by the time you see this, we'll probably be setting up the stand. Are we going to be in the same place, Dave?
I think we're going to be... Are we on the balcony, John, again this year? We'll be on the balcony with our big stand. We'll have all the workers of the week.
Oh, yeah, we're also going to have a list of what not to buy.
And all our new releases as well. But more on that in a second. You can meet the team.
Okay, so who's on the stand? Well, first of all, there's me and you.
Me and you, we'll
I'm going to be demming all of my new stuff.
And it's a WMS... A-team, isn't it?
Well, it is, yeah. And we're giving away a free DVD. We'll get to that in a second. But aren't you going to be demming a whole bunch of the workers of the week? You've been learning as many as possible?
I've been trying to learn every single worker of the week so I can dem them, and that's my challenge.
Okay,
so
I'll be doing all the new stuff. We're also going to have Matthew Underhill there.
Robo-demmer.
There is not a thing in the shop that he cannot dem. He picks something up and he can literally do it within half an hour. So your challenge to Matthew, come onto the stand and say, show me that.
Superhuman. I guarantee
he'll be able to do it. Yeah,
there'll be Wheeler Dealer Jim.
Wheeler Dealer Jim Trainer. He's going to be there and he's going to be coming in and out, and he loves it when a plan comes together.
When he actually gets up from his hangover from the night before, he's going to have some amazing deals.
And
he'll
if you're there, he might just make a deal, and the first couple of people that grab it, there you go, that's it.
So come up to the stand and say, Wheeler Dealer Jim, give me a deal.
And then you've got Howling Mad John Farr.
He is mad. He puts some incredible deals together, don't you, John?
Yeah, absolutely. John's like, yeah, whatever. Well, yeah, Howling Mad John Farr. And then finally, we have Karen of David and Karen.
Yeah, Karen is my magic partner. She's going to be giving away the free DVD. DVD, which is like A-team themed. And there's loads of stuff on there. 2 hours of footage, some bonus footage, including David J's full sleeving lecture from Lads. And that'll be Karen doing that.
And David J's going to be on the stand as well.
Yeah.
But hang on, Karen, aren't I your magic partner as well?
Well, you've seen Karen, haven't you?
Yeah, but...
Say no more, Craig.
But right. Dave J's going to be there as well. If you've ever met David J, he's a real character. So come onto the stand and say hi. And we should talk about some of our new releases.
Well, first of all, one I'm really looking forward to is Love Cards. You've got it there.
I've actually got it. I keep it in my wallet at all times.
What's the basic concept behind it?
Well, it's a mentalism routine that myself and Russell Leeds have developed.
You and Russell Leeds. Can I just mention something? On the ad copy, right, there's kind of this big love heart.
Yeah.
And it says Craig Petty and Russell Leeds in the middle of the love heart.
That's right, yeah.
That does make you look a little bit gay.
I'm not gay, though.
No. You're not gay.
I'm not gay.
In fact...
But actually, that brings us to a very important point.
Yeah, actually, we'll not say any more on this.
This is quite serious.
Could we invite Jonathan Farr in, please, for our statement?
Hello. My name is Jonathan Farr, partner and retail manager at World Magic Store. I would just like to say good afternoon to all the viewers of the Wizard Product Review before I read this short statement. Good afternoon, viewers. Recently, the alleged comment of Joe Monty Esquire has been brought to our attention. These comments have caused offence to the WMS team and many of our close friends and viewers. You are not a nice person, Mr. Monty. As a result of these comments, and having listened to our viewers and customers, we have decided to take the following action. With immediate effect, all of the Joe Monty's products will be removed from the World Magic Store website and taken out of these premises and discarded of. We will never mention this matter again, and we will never review one of your products again. Thank you to all our customers and people that have commented on YouTube and the Magic Cafe that has helped us arrive at this statement. Thanks very much, guys.
Thanks, John.
Cheers, John.
Right, okay.
So anyway, love cards.
Love cards.
Nice beer.
We've got a bit of a live performance here. This is a no-frills kind of trailer.
Yeah, we didn't want to hide anything, so I went down to a restaurant. I grabbed my love cards. We found a table of girls, and I sat down with them. And we got the following footage.
And you made magic happen.
I made magic happen.
With those girls.
They loved it. Check it out.
What's your name?
Becky.
Becky, I'm Craig. How's it going? Okay. What's your name?
Lauren.
Hey, Lauren. How's it going? And what's your name?
Faith.
Faith? Yeah. Nice name. Right, okay. I'm going to try something a little bit weird on you right now. We're going to do mind reading, mentalism sort of thing. I'm going to try and read your mind. Actually, I'm going to try and read your mind.
Right.
I can see you're excited about this. Let me ask you a question. Have you guys ever seen those wallet cards? You can kind of buy them for your boyfriend, or you can buy them for your girlfriend or something like that. You know when you've got little cards and it's got poetry on them and it's for different occasions?
Yeah.
You can get them from birthdays and Clinton's cards. I've got a whole stack here. Like I said, I'm married and my wife is obsessed with these things. It's an absolute nightmare. Like, she'll buy them me for every occasion, and if I don't keep them in my wallet all the time, I'm in so much trouble. And you can get them for everything. I don't know if you've seen them before. Like this one, well, let me show you a few of them. This one's Happy Birthday. She bought me that for my birthday a few years ago. You got Merry Christmas, obviously what that one's for. Get Well Soon. You know, there's a whole stack of them. Party Time, you know, you got a whole different bunch. But anyway, we're going to try something, okay? Now, this is what we're going to do. I'm going to try and do a little bit of mentalism sort of thing.
Okay.
But there's 10 cards here.
Yeah.
And each one of these cards, as standard, they all have 10 lines of text. So you have like a heading there, and then you have 10 lines of text underneath. Each line has about 7 to 10 words. So if you think about it, there's something like 700 to 1,000 words on these cards.
Yeah.
What we're going to do is we're going to eliminate these down to, a lot less than that, to be perfectly honest. Here's what's going to happen. You're going to think of a number between 1 and 10. Don't tell anyone the number, but think of a number in your head between 1 and 10.
Okay.
Now, what you're going to do, you can use that number to get to a card. So if you thought of one, you'd take one card, put it to the bottom of the packet, and then you'd look at that card. So in this case, you're brilliant. Okay? And I'm sure you are. If you thought of two, you'd do 1, 2. You'd look at the bottom card. In this case, Merry Christmas. You get the idea. One more time. If you thought of 7, for example, you'd go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then you'd look at the bottom card.
Okay?
So I'm going to give you these. Now I'm going to turn away because I don't want to see what you're doing. Whatever number you're thinking of, put that many to the bottom and then look at that card. You can make sure I'm not looking. I'm going to turn away. You can keep me honest because somebody's got to. Okay? I don't want to, and count quietly. I don't want to be able to pick up on the sound and know what number you're thinking of. It's very important that no one knows the number. Are you done that? No, she's still counting. That's fine.
Done it. Can I look?
Okay, yeah, have a look at that card. In fact, just pass me the rest back. The only important thing is the card that you're looking at. Don't worry about any of the others. Just pass me the others back.
The whole stack?
Yeah, just everything except for the card you're looking at.
Oh, except for the one. Okay.
You got it?
Yeah.
Fantastic. Now, I don't want to look.
Okay.
There's 10 lines of text underneath the title.
Yeah.
Now, the number you're thinking of, I don't know it. Nobody knows it. Are you happy with that number?
Yeah.
You don't want to change number. Is that fine?
No, that's fine.
Okay. Whatever number you've got, I want you to go down to that line. So if you were thinking of 3, you'd look down at the 3rd line. If you were thinking of 7, you look down at the 7th line. If you were thinking of 10, you go to the very bottom line. You get the idea?
Yeah.
And read that line a couple of times in your head. Don't read it out loud, obviously, but read it in your head. And then what I want you to do, when you've read that line a couple of times, what I want you to do is pick one of the words in that line, make it a nice long word, something that you can focus on, and remember that word. Have you done that?
Yeah.
And then put the card away. Have you done that?
Yep.
In fact, just don't let me see anything. Put your hands over everything, okay? So think about this for a minute. You thought of a number. No one could know the number but you.
Okay.
You then went to a random card. I then gave you the option to change your mind and go for a different number. You kept the same number. You looked at that line, and you've looked at a word on that line. Is it fair to say that nobody but you could know what that word is?
Yeah, only me.
Only you.
Yeah.
And there's like 1,000 words to pick from.
Yeah.
So what I want you to do now is focus on that word. Really get a mental image in your mind of that word. Focus on the word. Imagine you're in a cinema, and on the cinema screen is that word flashing over and over again in neon sign. Can you do that for me?
Yeah.
In fact, focus on the first letter of that word. Focus on the first letter.
Yeah.
Just the first letter, it's flashing over and over again. Send it to me now. Is it an S?
Yeah. Oh, God.
Brilliant. Well, let's try another letter. Think of another letter.
In the same word?
Yeah, in the same word. Think of another letter in there.
okay, yeah.
Send it to me. There's another S in there, isn't there?
Yeah.
There is another S in there.
There is.
And there's a T.
Yep.
What? Hang on. There's a P.
Yep.
Concentrate on the word. Say it over and over in your head. Shout it over and over in your head. 1, 2, 3. Stupendous.
It is as well. No, it isn't. That's the word.
1,000 words. You went down to 1. Stupendous.
Yep.
But this is even weirder. Think about this. You thought of a number.
Yeah.
You never wrote the number down.
Yeah. No.
You never did anything with that number. It's been in your head and your head only. I even told you you could change the number, but you didn't. You're thinking of one number.
Yeah.
One number only. Imagine a computer screen with the number flashing over and over again.
Mm-hmm.
Think of that now. Were you thinking of 6?
Oh my god, yeah.
That's really freaky.
Oh my god.
That's pretty nuts.
That is. I don't know how you know that.
I'm in tune.
That's scary.
That is scary.
You know what? Thank you so much for helping me. I really appreciate it. I hope you enjoyed that. You guys take care of yourself. Thank you very much. You guys have a nice evening. All right? See you again. Take care.
So that's Love Cards. It really is that good. Come and see it performed live. Really is that clean. They can pick any number. They can change the number.
They can pick any number. They can change the number. There's no memorization. There's no fishing. There's no multiple outs. There's no forcing of any kind. It's just really clean. It's an instant reset, ready to go. It's in your wallet and you're ready to go anytime, anywhere. It really is a book test in your wallet
by
myself.
Fits in one compartment.
Yeah, I've got it.
It
fits in one compartment. I normally have it in 2 because I don't have much in my wallet. But I know Russ, when he performs it, he just has it in one compartment like that, which is fine. You can do it whichever way you want.
Absolutely fantastic. Something else you've got coming out.
Yeah,
Tell us about CHOP.
Okay, CHOP is a routine that I've been holding back for at least 2 or 3 years now. And it is exceptional. You know, I know a lot of people have said that it's my best release to date. I know that
very commercial.
Dave Forrest and Ben Williams
Alan
and
Morrison.
Alan Morrison, they've given some great quotes to it. Let me just synopsisize the routine for you. Basically, it's a chop cup routine, but you can use any cup.
Any cup.
And the idea is you borrow a £10 note, or any note really.
I use
a £10 note, but any bill. You get them to sign it. You ball it up into a ball, and then you do a multi-phase chop cup routine with the paper cup and the ball. And it's very visual. There is stuff that you can do with this that you can't do with a normal chop cup. You can hold the cup, you can drop the ball in, it instantly vanishes. There's a really nice moment, very Tommy Wonder-esque, I think Kaelin would like it, where you drop the ball in, you tip it into their hands, it vanishes, and it's back on the table.
Back on the table, yeah. And into their hand,
They feel it going into their hand, they feel it disappearing off the hand. You literally have it disappear from under
the
a
kicker
cup.
Is you produce a lemon, nothing new there, of course. It's a chop cup routine,
but you take
the bill and kind of rub the bill into the lemon. They immediately check the lemon.
They examine the lemon to their heart's content.
There's no gaps or splits in the lemon or anything like that, and then you do the impossible.
You just cut open the lemon and inside is the bill. And it is really that clean. It's perfect for restaurants. There's alternate handling, so if you don't want to have it go into the lemon, you don't have to. That is the way I perform it. And also on there is a bonus routine, which I use as an opening into CHOP, which is a very visual pen routine that's almost a coin flurry, but with a pen, and that looks amazing.
It looks fantastic. And on the DVD, you've got 3 live performances.
Yeah, yeah.
And something like an hour and a half to teach the whole routine.
Yeah, I've gone into real depth. And the live performances, there's 3 performances. There's one done to stand up with a whole bunch of sort of blokey blokes.
Yeah.
There's a big table where there's about 10 or 15 people and did it on the big table.
Yeah.
And then there was one where I did it to just a couple of people. So it's a very, very good routine. That's coming out of Blackpool.
So we've also got the Nightshade coin set
as well.
Tell us about that.
Well, everyone knows that a couple of years ago I released the Mirage coin set, and that was very well received amongst coin magicians. I've had the idea for Nightshade longer than I have Mirage, and I never thought I was going to release it, but you guys managed to convince me somehow, and it's available for release at Blackpool. It's another coin set. You get, I think, about 6 gimmicks with it.
Yeah.
And the idea is the 6 routines on the DVD that use those gimmicks. Some of the routines use all of them. Some of the routines
My favourite is the copper silver routine. You can show the copper and the silver coin on both sides, immediately go into the cleanest commercial copper silver routine you've ever seen, and then at the end both coins vanish.
And what's nice about the copper silver is it takes it almost to three fly levels, because it's done up here, so they see a copper, see a silver, and when they look back they've changed. There's a lot of kickbacks in it, there's a lot of very visual moments.
You've got to see it live. It'd be best to come up, actually see Craig do the routines on the stand.
The routine I used to in my competition act, the three fly is in there,
the nightshade routine.
The nightshade routine, you produce three coins, you have them jump from one hand to another, and then you vanish them. It's very, very clean, very, very easy to perform, and very, very strong. But my favourite routine on the DVD is Triple C, which is a coins across, where you have a silver coin, a copper coin, and a Chinese coin. You very cleanly put them into your hand, one at a time, no false transfers, nothing held back. You show this hand empty, you make a fist, and then the coins jump from this hand to this hand, but the spectator names the order that the coins jump across. So if the spectator said Chinese, you'd then open up this hand and show the Chinese coin was there. Then if they said silver, you'd then open up this hand and show the Chinese and the silver coin was there. And there's no wordplay, there's no equivoque, Max Maven, nothing like that. Whatever coins they name, that is the order that they jump across.
It's awesome. The best thing, we could talk about it all day, but it's best just come and see it if you're at Blackpool. We'll have a trailer out after Blackpool on the web, but the only place to see it live is at Blackpool next weekend, when you dem it and premiere the Nightshade coin set
Nightshade
for the first time.
Set, exactly.
That's Nightshade, we've got Chop, we've got Love Cards.
And anybody who's been to Blackpool and come to the World Magic Store stand, you will know that we are a big fan of making crazy deals, and we're going to have some more crazy deals on the stand at Blackpool this year. So it's worthwhile coming over. If there's something you like, we'll make you a deal.
See you there. As we've been talking about our Blackpool releases this week, we've only got time for one more review, and it's Extreme Snowstorm by Paul Romany and Marcus Jarling.
Well, I know Kevin James did the original Snowstorm, and you were the first person in the UK to ever perform that.
Yeah, I did it. Did it in a couple of competitions, that sort of thing. It's a fantastic effect. It's a beautiful effect on stage. And the nice thing about this gimmick is you can use it pretty much anywhere.
Yeah, I mean, if you look at the footage, Paul does it holding a mobile phone, and a snowstorm just appears from behind a mobile phone, and he takes a newspaper and it appears from behind a newspaper. It
and
looks very good.
Lots of different applications for both close-up and stage with the gimmick that you get. The gimmick, it's first class. Mm-hmm. It's not cheap, but it is first class.
It looks
very,
excellent.
Very well made. I know Paul Daniels has been using this in pantomime.
Oh, really? I didn't know
for
that.
Like sort of 50 shows or something. And given the guys that have produced this, a fantastic letter of recommendation.
Well, that's it.
You can't get better than that, really.
Yeah, exactly.
I like the other applications, the thing like the handkerchief coming out of the pocket.
Yeah, because you don't just have to shoot confetti. You can shoot anything out of it that you want to. And yeah, he's got a really nice thing where a hanky just appears.
And I like, imagine a kids show performer where you're waiting for something to explode, and he's got that bit where the case is open and there's like an explosion.
I know when I walked into the unit this morning, Dave had this thing and he was like, Craig! And fired it about 100 sponge balls at me, and I was just, you can do it for that. You can make sponge balls.
Something out of Ghostbusters. It's about the size of, we don't want to expose the gimmick, but the gimmick itself is about the size of a Smarty tube. And it's got a lot more to it than that. It's precision made. Yeah, it's precision made. Although I used to do that when I was a kid, put the top on, then go around firing the top at
people. Yeah, okay. This is a bit more high tech.
Bit more advanced than that. It's not cheap. Have a look at the footage. It's a fantastic piece of equipment. At Blackpool, we'll be the only dealer with this. So if you want to come up and see it, you want to find out a bit more about it, come over to the World Magic Store stand and ask to find out a little bit more about Extreme Snowstorm. It's not really one of our products, so we're happy to review it. It's a fantastic bit of kit. If you want to do that effect, I'm giving this 90%.
Yeah, I think I'm going to actually start using this. I like it. I'm going to give it 90%
as well.
You said
you're going to use it in your kid show for the explosion.
Yeah,
thing
I'm going to put it in my kid show. When I open the case, the thing's going to explode. And maybe even walk around. Maybe a show reel I think it might be good on as well. 90%.
Really cool. Come and see it at Blackpool. So we've got a big announcement right now.
We've got a huge announcement. Would you like to make it, or would you?
You say it.
Okay. Well, some of you might have seen this, some of you might not have, but we have now got our own area on the Magic Cafe. As you all know, I'm on the Magic Cafe a lot. You're on the Magic Cafe Not a lot, but I'm on there all the time. And
I read it on my phone.
It's the place to come and ask us questions about what you've seen on the show. You know, we're always there responding and talking to people. And we've now got our own area on the Magic Cafe where we've got different, you can talk about different shows and ask us questions.
We'd love for you, if we review something, whether you agree with it or not, actually post under and let us know your own review.
We really like the feedback.
If you have got the same product.
Because, you know, if we do things that you like, we want to know about it. If we do things that you don't like, we also want to know about it. The only way that we can improve and get better is with you telling us what you want to see. That sounds right, doesn't it?
Yeah. That's all right. Yeah, yeah, I think that's pretty much
it. I think that covered it.
We didn't write that down like John's statement, but that's fine.
No, that's good.
The other thing, we're going to be at Blackpool. We're about to start getting everything ready. It's a busy, busy week,
yep.
But we'd like to set a challenge right now.
This is our challenge to you.
The creators out there. Mm-hmm. We've got a video camera. We're going to be at Blackpool. Derek Lever and Russ Stevens have given us special permission to film on our stand. If you've got a product that you think is up to the scrutiny of the Wizard Product Review, come and dem it to us on our stand in front of the video camera.
Oh yeah, but you know our reputation. You know, you've got to make sure that it's a good product. But even if it's not an actual product and you've just got an idea, I'd like to see that as well. What about you?
I'd love to see it. So come and see us on the stand. That is an open challenge to all creators out there. But that's it this week for the Wizard Product Review.
We'll see you next week. We're going to have a whole bunch of footage from Blackpool.
Hopefully, if the creators come over. But we're going to get some other stuff as well.
Oh, yeah, we're going to get some other
Follow
stuff.
Us in all the usual places. We'll see you next week. I'm Dave.
I'm Craig.
And that was the Wizard Product Review for this week.